We're coming to you from Golf Course Hotel Kampala, where World Vision are celebrating 30 years of existence in Uganda. This is one of the organizations that have been fundamental in transforming lives of people in this country since 1990, when the war that brought the NRA government into power had just come to an end. And then later in the 1990s, when HIV/AIDS was prevailing in areas like Rakai and Masaka. I spoke to the chairman of the board of World Vision, Dr. Fred Muhumusa, who highlighted to me the journey of the organization.
So our first years of operation were in Luero, and of course you can remember 30 years back, the country had just come out of war, at least Luero itself. So we were in there to begin putting families back together, putting systems back in place. We later on moved into Rakai, and that was because of the HIV/AIDS pandemic that was there at the time. We have had operations in northern Uganda because of the war again that has been there. And we've had operations in eastern Uganda in the Soroti area. Right now, as we speak, we are in West Nile. But also we still stay in these other areas because ours has an emergency component, but we also have a development phase. So we stay in an area for at least up to 15 years to make sure the communities have picked up and they are now able to support the children with a good environment to grow in.
During these 30 years, the organization has faced quite a number of challenges, which also Dr. Mumza discussed with me and also showed the way forward.
As we speak now, we have huge global challenges for humanitarian ventures like ours. The people who donate resources are not financially aware. In the developed world, that's where a lot of that support comes from. We are now looking for options of how we can keep the good work that is going on by mobilizing other alternative resources. We're looking at domestic resources. We're appealing to Ugandans out there who want to help somebody and maybe have no means of helping that person. They can partner with us, we can partner with them and be able to reach out to them.
In the house for the function are the beneficiaries of World Vision. I've discussed with many who joined World Vision 27 years ago, 15 years ago, 30 years ago, and they really say that if it wasn't for this organization, they wouldn't be what they are today. My name is Solomon Kawesa here at Golf Course Hotel.